Hello, and welcome to the Movie Universe. I'm your host, Movie Fan. Today, I'm going to be talking about the Forgotten Easter special, Peter and the Magic Egg. The story starts off with the animals of the Doppler farm going to see Uncle Amos because he was going to tell them a little story. And it goes something like this. Years ago on the Doppler farm, the animals were just animals, and the farm was very poor because of a terrible man named Tobias Tin Whiskers. He pretty much owned all the land in the area, and even the town, because he was the richest man there. Or I should say, the richest tin man there. He's got his eye on the Doppler farm, and he demands to get the mortgage, or else out they go. And shortly after Tin Whiskers leaves, the Dopplers discover a baby in the hen house. There was a note attached to the baby saying that his name is Peter Paws. They adopt him and raised him, and in a few short months, Peter grew up to be a teenager, which suggested that he was no ordinary child. It's proven even more when he gives all the animals gifts that make them walk and talk. Tin Whiskers, of course, comes back making threats that the farm will be his if they don't pay the mortgage. It is after that moment that we learn about his origin. Years ago, he was just an ordinary farmer named Tobias Toot, but he came into some money and bought a tractor. The tractor, of course, gave him a huge advantage over the other farms, and he ended up making a bigger profit. After that, he grew to love his machine so much that he went to the big city and hired a plastic doctor and two motor engineers and got himself made mechanical. Yeah, who knew they could do that back then? Anyway, as the other farms failed, he takes them over, mows it all down, and makes room for more machines. And the Dopplers are next on the list. However, Peter has a plan. He plans to go see Mother Nature. The animals, of course, go with him, and he tells them that Mother Nature is actually his mom. And believe it or not, she actually gave Peter to the Dopplers because he was the one who'd be able to help them. They go to see Mother Nature, and she leaves them a contract to supply eggs to the Easter Bunny. They go back to the farm, lay all the eggs and color them, and the Easter Bunny picks them up. You never see him, but you see his shadow. The next day, they pay Tin Whiskers what they owe him. Of course, he doesn't accept defeat just yet. Instead, he challenges Peter to a plowing contest, to which he cheats by covering up an old well. And during the plowing contest, Peter falls right into the well, and he's literally in a coma for the entire year. The animals go to see Mother Nature, and she gives them a magic egg. She tells them that what's inside that egg will awaken Peter. They take turns keeping the egg warm, and when it's about ready to hatch, Tin Whiskers shows up and steals it. And after a little back and forth, the egg hatches, and inside is a duck. And not just any duck, because he was actually a clown. And he was so funny that all the animals, including the Dopplers themselves, were laughing their heads off. And in turn, the laughter wakes Peter up. And a little bit later, even Tin Whiskers was laughing so hard that he molted his metal shell. And so he became good once again. He gave back all the farms, and he actually became a farmhand for the Dopplers. Now that Peter's task is done, he goes back to Mother Nature. And that's how the story ends. It's a good little special, definitely worth watching. It's got some catchy songs, some great animation, and a pretty solid story. Although, with all honesty, some of the singing is a little eh sometimes because, I'm sorry, but whoever it was that was doing the singing for Peter was not really very good at it. What's really interesting about this is really the fact that it's actually, in a way, a promo for Paws. Now, if the name sounds familiar, that would be the egg dyeing kits that come out every Easter. And if the animals in this story look a little familiar to you, that's because these are the same animals that you find on those Paws egg dyeing kits. And come to think of it, Peter's last name was Paws, wasn't it? Coincidence? Of course not. Another interesting fact about this special is Uncle Amos, who is our narrator in the story. He's voiced by actor Ray Bolger. You would know him better as the Scarecrow from the 1939 classic movie, The Wizard of Oz. It's a great little special, one that everyone should see. In fact, if you want to see it, I'll put the link below so you can find it. I recommend that if you ever get the time, look it up. I'm pretty sure you'll like it. This is Movie Fan wishing y'all a happy Easter.